Hello friend, welcome to Marine Engineering Hub. This is Ravi Gupta. Today we are going to talk about full bore safety valve. In full bore safety valve, we will see why the full bore safety valve design was implemented, in which pressure the full bore is used, and after that we will explain the basic working of the full bore safety valve. But before beginning the video, I want to tell you that I have made a video regarding improved high loop safety valve. This three safety valve, full bore safety valve, improved high loop safety valve, and full loop safety valve. This three safety valve is mainly asked in MEO class 2, MEO class 4 exam, both in oral and written exam. So please watch the full series of the safety valve, and for that you can click on the I button right now, where you will go to the play section and you can watch that. So let's begin the video of the full bore safety valve. So the first question come to our mind, that why full bore safety valve design is implemented in high pressure boiler. So basically what happened? With increase in temperature, problem arises such as the distortion of the spring and the valve seat occur over a period of time. So what happened basically? As you can see, this is a improved high loop safety valve design. So as you can see, when the valve is lifted, the steam pressure is acting directly on the lower spring carrier whenever the steam is escaping. At that time, what happened? As the steam which is escaping from the valve area also acting on the lower spring carrier, so the spring is in direct contact with the escaping steam. As the pressure of the boiler increases, therefore the temperature of the steam also increases, and when this spring are subjected to such a high temperature, it is subjected to a distortion, and hence affect the functioning of the valve and also reduce the running hour or overall interval of the time of the safety valve. For that reason, in high pressure boiler, full bore safety valve design was implemented. Another problem arises, that valve was unable to close smartly, leading to the large blowdown effect and also wire drawing. So basically what happened, when the valve after the steam pressure is released used to sit, at that time a thin film of layer used to form, which prevent the valve to sit very smoothly. The design of improved high loop safety valve, however, overcome this problem, but still some amount of blowdown effect was there. It means, what do you mean blowdown effect? It means that after the design pressure is reached, the steam is still escaping from the safety valve and causing the loss of the steam, and the while the valve is sitting at that time. It means what happened earlier, that when the safety valve was designed to lift at 3% above the working pressure, at that time is used to lift at 3% above the working pressure, but when at time of sitting, it should sit just well below the design pressure or at design pressure, but due to blowdown effect, it used to sit much lower stream pressure. For that reason, this problem was overcome by the full bore safety valve. Another problem was the wire drawing. What is a wire drawing? It is a condition in which a thin film of steam blow across between the valve face and causes cutting of the valve face, which led to the loss of the steam. So basically, during the blowdown effect, as the valve was sitting, a thin film of steam was continuously escaping. Sometime when the valve was finally too close position, at that time this steam was acting as a wire, causing a cutting on the valve surface, and this cutting causes the leaking of the valve and also reducing the efficiency of the boiler. To prevent this problem and sharp closure, full bore safety valve was implemented. So what we have learned? We have learned that full bore safety valve design has implemented because of two problems. One, spring distortion due to high temperature operation as is subjected to direct steam. Second, because of problem of a large blowdown effect and wire drawing. So to overcome this, full bore safety valve design was implemented. So full bore safety valve is used in a high pressure boiler where the working pressure is above 20 bar. So This problem was implemented for a high pressure boiler. In low and medium pressure boiler, this problem was not much there and was still in the acceptable limit. And for that reason, this full bore safety valve design was implemented for a high pressure boiler. So now let's see the design of a full bore high lift safety boiler. So as you can see here, this is the boiler steam which will be escaping through this. It'll come here and it will escape through this. Okay. Now there are two valves. One is the main valve, second is the control valve. The steam pressure is acting both on a main valve and through this steam control line, it acting on a control valve. Once when the pressure has exceeded the design pressure limit, that is 3% above the working pressure, design pressure, at that time the steam will go from here and it will act on this surface. As it will act on this surface, at that time what will happen, this valve will be lifted against the spring. As it will lift it against the spring, it will find a passage and this steam will go and will act on the operating piston area. Operating piston surface area is almost twice or four times of the main valve area. And as we know, force is equal to pressure into surface area. Therefore, the force applied generated because of the steam pressure will be much higher, which will cause the valve to, which cause this piston, operating piston to push in this direction. Because of this operating steam will be pushed in this direction, and as it will be pushed in this direction, the main valve will open. As the main valve will open, the steam will come from here and will go out. One thing to notice, when the operating piston valve is moving at this time the return spring is getting compressed, which is causing the sharp closure of the valve when this steam acting from the control valve is closed. So what is happening when the steam is coming from here and pressure is exceeded and it is causing the opening of the main valve, the pressure is released instantaneously. When the pressure has fall just below design pressure, at that time this control valve will sit. As the control valve will sit, it will cause the top surface of the steam pressure acting area, the steam will escape from a vent here, provided from a vent the steam will escape. As the steam will escape, a vacuum will be created here and with the help of return spring it will return back and close. So as you can see in this design, the return spring is not in direct contact with the waste steam, and hence it prevent the distortion of the waste steam. Second thing is that because of the operating piston area is much larger than the main valve, it provides sharp opening, and sharp closing of the valve is provided with the help of the return spring. Second thing is that the operational control is being provided by the control valve. This control valve is provided with a vent which will vent the top part of this system and the top part of this system when it is closed. So this is how a full bore safety valve work. Now let's see the explanation. The main valve operating is controlled by the pilot control valve. Okay, as you have seen there, when the pressure inside the boiler is increased, at that time the control valve will lift up, which will provide the passage to the operating piston. So as I have told you, when it will lift up, it will provide a passage to the operating piston. Okay, the operating piston area is twice of the main valve area. So the surface area of the operating piston is twice of the main valve area. And as I have told you, pressure into area is equal to force. If the area is more and pressure is same, if the area is more, the force generated will be more. So the force generation will be more, twice of the main valve. So when the steam acting on the operating piston, it causes the opening of the main valve against the spring. as the diameter is twice of the main ball, it causes a D by 4 lift of the main ball. That is, the full lift of the safety valve is achieved by the full bore safety valve. The flow rate at which the steam flow out through this main valve is 4 times the discharge capacity of the ordinary safety valve. Very important point. So what two things we need to care, that because of the sharp opening, the full lift means, what do you mean by full lift? Means the maximum, the amount of steam escaping area is provided by the full bore safety valve, and hence the lift achieved is D by 4, which was D by 12 in the case of an improved value safety valve, but D by 4 for the full bore safety valve. Second thing is that when we compare the discharge capacity of the full bore safety valve with the ordinary safety valve, it is 4 times more than the full bore, than the ordinary safety valve. Okay, now this is another design which showing that how the valve, control valve, is venting when it is closed. When it is open, opening, the vent is closed, and when it is sitting back, the vent is open. So this is how the full bore safety valve works. I hope you learn in this video how a full bore safety valve operation carried out. If you have any doubt, please do comment below, I will reply. And if you like the video, please hit the like button and please do subscribe. Please subscribe. I guarantee you that you will learn a lot through my all video, and please do watch my other video. Image credit goes to GS Flanagan. Thank you, friend. Have a good day.